Hello, I'm French and welcome to your Russian Overkill, a newly released Doom mod, working with the likes of GZ Doom and Scare Tag. This mod is a weapon mod, and obviously Team Russian and weapons registry because it is ton of fun. It doesn't replace enemies though, which is a good thing because I want to see like dumb, stupid enemies that could kill me very easily. I think overall this is a great mod to revisit old map packs were a bit too hard and just blow everything up. So let's see, we have three characters, I'll be showing in three. Let's start with Aloza just for, because it's practical to play. We have different settings for difficulty. First one is just you invisible, simply. Second one is standard ultra violence. And the other one would like make enemies have more health. Like this one is 3 times. This one is 5. This one is 7 and removes the ultimate weapons, which we don't want to do because they're funny as fuck. And Stalin's after you, increase it by 10, remove super weapons and remove power-ups. So, yeah, not as fun. So there's a hidden difficulty setting, let's say just kill them. You die in 1 hit, but everything else dies in 1 hit as well. Seeing most weapons explode, this can be hard. Let's just play on a struggle for freedom. So medium difficulty, I suppose. Alright, so this is Scythe 2, one of the more common megawards, classic. Nothing too special. And here is our melee weapon. We just fire bullets and shotgun shells, maybe if it happens, it's kind of random. Yes. Oh, it's 15 hair. Our pistol is a very loud gun, and it might not seem that impressive, but remember that enemies have 5 times the normal health. So it can kill zombie men with 5 health in 1 hit, which is like something like 400 or 400 health or something. In the normal difficulty, I mean, the difficulty without any increase of health for enemies, it can kill a demon, like maybe a revenant in 1 hit. But this is a shotgun, it's Erasus. It's an anti-tank shotgun. The name says the spread is huge. And it's pretty damn good. It's explosive, so of course you damage yourself with it. That goes with saying. So the power-ups and the weapons are replaced. Pretty much everything, every item. Like here we got a shield, which is, you know, mainly made to protect yourself rather than from the enemies. Seeing all weapons are so explosive. We also have some items. We have a post-team, which make us run very fast. Not exactly useful. And we have bullet casing. And yeah, shotgun shares casings for some reason. And let me show you why this is actually interesting. Like, which is the secondary fire here. We can throw back the casing at the enemies. This is just retarded but fun. Love this. Alright, let's get our hands on the pushka. Anti-tank gun, 1 millimeter. Explosive. Yes, kill a cacodemon in 2 hits effortlessly with 5 times health. Let's get another weapon. It's a war gear combat rifle. So this may seem a bit boring, but we can add barrels and does a thing. Like so. And we have 3 barrels, so it means fire 3 times as much bullets. Like so. And it kills 5 times health demons in half a second. Alright, this is a power-up we get. Instead of the brother pack, you get power-ups and permanently improve your weapons. So this makes... Actually, this one is a different one. Yeah, all explosive projectiles gain higher firepower. No, I actually don't get this one at this point. So let's try this with a pushka. Second. Yeah. So this one is a bit different, so it looks like we have a more powerful weapon now. So the one that you usually get is the one that increases your bullets. Makes all your bullets explosive. Which is again ludicrous. So let's see. So it's this weapon too, what this character has. It is a ammo packs. So you can throw ammo packs every low recharge, just like in, I guess, Battlefield, you could say. Except it is very bugged and often you get 999 of every item. Yeah. So let's not use this right now and just go to the next level. Oh, you Stalin. Oh, Alright, let's try these items, shall we? First, enter Seeker pickup. It's actually the bar that's going to... Yes, go and explode itself on enemies, but not die. Itself for some reason. Pretty silly. Let's see, what do we have? The Stalin... Like, nuclear warhead? I really don't know what it does, actually. It's kinda hard. Anvil Sphere make you not take damage from like lava like this, but as a work against enemies. So if I get fired on by like hims, I take no damage. And you might have noticed I have 2000 health and armor. Melee attacks still damage you, whatever. And so does you on shots. I took 10 damage from demon here. Alright. Before getting the items, let's get this. Power Warming minigun. It is a very subtle weapon. Let's look at that. Yeah. Very subtle. I love it. Love it. Alright. Second effect of this weapon is to convert your bullet casing, or bullet, in health. Doesn't make sense, but it's useful. Alright, get the shotgun back. Let's see, what else can we try? Salvation Sphere. If you activate it, and you die, you respawn at start of level. This Ouija Sphere, I have no clue. It just makes you see in dark and probably something else. Notice that the shotgun makes quite damage ammo sound without being quite damaged. And we got the shell power-up. I think I noticed. Let's see. Yes. Our shells gain higher firepower. Just in case, you know? Oh, we really needed that. Oh yeah, we got the one for the bullets as well. So now this weapon is just completely stupid. Alright. What else can we try? Redeemer, not right now. Jet thruster will make you fly for a little while. Like, very short while. So you can go past things by flying. Yeah, Hogger. Let's try this. It is a grenade. It takes time to activate, come on. And does this! It is pretty effective. Now let's try our new weapon, which I actually forgot the name. Bumpanku. Double Poshka, double 100mm cannon. So you can fire in a happy succession. Ah, still alive. So we can show secondary fire. Yes, bunch of rockets. So you are like a, you know, Japanese mech or making white wires or whatever. You have the same amount of firepower. And this is not the best weapon. We still have a few to see. Oh, got some big explosions. So yeah, the enemies may have more health, but they still do the same amount of damage. And those are not really dangerous. And I forgot the key up here. Good use for jet thrusters. Nice. Oh, yeah, of course, the 100mm shells are named Len. That makes sense. Yeah, Drone is still alive. Damn, son. I can't see with the weapons that they do use knockback, but since enemies have more health, they might not die, but still be knocked back, like, very high in here. Hair. It is fun. Oh, poor monkey bye. Alright. Still a few things to show. Let's progress in this level a bit to show you the... Yes, yeah, the Fish Storm device. It is a pretty fun one. Just mow down the guys, nothing too much interesting. With our health and ammo, it's not even making a problem. We all have this gun here. Oh yeah, actually it says Mammoth Tank Armament, so I didn't notice that at first. So I guess it's from, you know, World Alert. Pretty good reference. Okay, some power-ups were changed to, this is like double damage. Sphere, just in case, you know, you didn't do enough damage. Alright, let's see the Shift Storm device. for also a new weapon. Alright. It takes a time to activate. Another prison fire, yes. So this is what this thing does. Very subtle. Very precise strike. And it's gonna say that most of the shots just go out of the map. I think this is pretty sad. Alright, let's show our last items. Oh, Seeker card makes you rockets. Seek enemies, I think. Not really supposed to do that, but not really doing it. Alright. Now let's try the Redeemer. You know, you might think this is like an UT, like missile, doing a big explosion. Let's try it on this one Gecko Demon. That was pretty effective. Alright, shown pretty much everything at this point. Let's show those other characters kind of quick. So we're playing Alosa. Let's try Yuri. Yuri starts with this Hydra handgun, which is pretty good. So then if I put it in auto-fire mod, I like it. And you have the explosive bullets when you get the upgrades, obviously. And you can punch. Pretty standard, but effective. One thing to note though, with this character, you strafe slower, but you move forward very fast. I don't know why. Let's see the secondary fire of the melee weapon. And yes, it is a giant fart, and it goes through walls. Pretty effective. Alright, that's pretty much it for Yuri. He also makes like simple noise and stuff, whatever. Let's see Marty. Alright, Marty has some other kind of pistol. Let me give myself some ammo, so shoot the scony fire. Yes, you shoot rockets off this pistol. Why not? And these rockets are kind of going whatever they want. And now let's see his melee attack. So we can punch, we can kick. This is kind of boring, right? So let's keep kicking until something happens. Yes! So this is a kick from Mortal Kombat from Liu Kang. Let's try a melee attack now. Kind of boring again. But wait for it. It's kind of random. I have to wait for it to happen. Yes! Alright, this was, you know, Fist of the North Star, Kenshu, whatever. Tax, which is pretty funny as well. So there's a second one. And I hope it's going to happen before tomorrow. Yes! Alright, this is a reference to some Gmod video I've watched 10 million years ago. There's one is a reference to this as well. And actually didn't show melee attack of Alosa. I'm a dumbass. So let's see, melee attack. Yes, that's this. But the secondary attack is this. Yes, throw explosive. Screen. Wiring swing axe at enemy's face. Pretty effective. So some attack might be different. Let me try it again. No. Yes. You can fire a rocket chainsaw, which arm an enemies. I don't know the reference to something else I forgot, but I find it pretty damn funny. Alright. Let's see, showing the lesser, those small-ish weapons. This is the Schwarzburg. Let's spawn some token enemies. To try it. So it is a huge as fuck shotgun blast. Kill this Baron kind of easily. Let's see another. We can charge shells into the weapon. Up to 20 shells. It is pretty silly. And obviously, actually not obviously, but if you hold the mouse button, this happens. Subtle. Love it. Alright, anything we missed so far on the smallish weapons? Yeah, this one didn't really show up. I like it. Not very original, but pretty fun. And the flak explosions, Flaming Slashing Grenades. Pretty good. Oh, there's this one as well. Which one I really like. Fires a bunch of grenades all around. And he fires bouncing grenades. And only obviously you use one grenade and you have a lot of this. This thing and others, I'm going to show it now in the map. Let's go on map 30 of Scythe 2. Which is a very easy and map with very few enemies, obviously. Alright. So let's see what happens. We have this thing, which I'm going to show you just in a second. And this weapon with the Redeemer skin. So let's try the primary fire. Nice. Let's not give a try in to the secondary fire. Yes. This is very subtle. I love it. So now this weapon, the Stashnov, is basically a portable iron cannon. Obelisk of Nod. That's what I imply. It is not really effective. It is true the enemies have 5 times health, but all those opponents were doing fine. And this one not really. Let's cheat a bit again. And show those super weapons, the Yamato. Yes! This weapon reduced my health, or remove all my kill my health and killed the hidden icon of sin. Very, very subtle. Using this weapon you mostly kill yourself. But not here. Alright, let's come back here and it shows us if I missed anything. Yes, I did. Here we have the Morningstar, which is just a mace. And it's silent mace, of course. Very fun. Secondary attack is draw an enemy and punch him in the face. Let's try again. Yes. You could be saying get over here, obviously. Alright. And now this. This weapon can come in one hand and two hands variety. We have the one hand. Let's see what it does. Interesting. So you punch with a grenade, it explodes, deals the damage to you and throw you into the air. Actually, it does a jump, so in certain mods like Deus Vult, when the jumping is disabled, you will not go into the air, so you can spam it and kill enemies very easily with it. Fun weapon. Alright, let's see if I missed anything still. Show this. Oh, I shouldn't show the signifier of the Pushka. So being pretty effective weapon, first place, signifier is pretty interesting. It throws a power of energy, will push all enemies away, and repel all enemy shots. You can only have one at a time, but it costs only one ammo, so why not use it all the time if you can. Alright, comrade, yes, I show it in action a bit. Yes. Alright, now the Pushkin, this is this mod answered to a sniper rifle. And you could say that this one is a sniper rifle, but this one is description is like a sniper rifle. Let's look at its potential. Yes, this is a sniper rifle. Actually, yeah, no, this is a sniper rifle. Because it zooms, obviously. Right, before I die, let's try to show... Yeah, Yamato has shown that. Yeah, I've pretty shown everything, so let's just finish this in a bang. Perfect.